Hello there, everyone. So this is a story about taking an existing unmaintained project and creating a community-maintained project out of it. So the unmaintained project was called PyLlama, and we'll talk about the community-maintained project called PyLlama. A brief introduction about myself. I'm a security software developer at Walmart Labs, and I develop security microservices using Go and Python. I keep my Fridays to work on PyLlama, which is the project we'll talk about. So to understand what is PyLlama, we first need to know what is PyLlama, because PyLlama is a fork of PyLlama. So PyLlama is a core audit tool for Python and JavaScript. It wraps around other popular linters like PyCodeStyle, PyDocStyle, PyFlakes, Maccabi, Complexity Checker, and so on. It supports a couple of other linters like PyLint, GJSLint by extension packages. And it was written and maintained by Kirill Klinov in 2012. And he has done an excellent job of maintaining this for about 5 years. So it was maintained until 2017. And so the question is, why fork PyLlama? So in Walmart Labs, at my workplace, we were using PyLlama quite extensively to do our code audit. One thing it makes very simple is that we don't have to argue about coding conventions, the spaces and the tabs and everything else. We, as a team, we agreed, whatever PyLlama says, we'll just go with it. So in Python 3.7, PyLlama broke. The reason being, async became a keyword in Python 3.7. And PyLlama had a module named async. So it actually had a file named async.py, and that would no longer compile because Python 3.7 has async as a reserved keyword. The solution, of course, is quite simple. You just rename that module into to a different name, which we eventually did. So when PyLlama broke for us, I started exploring what we can do to fix the situation, because PyLlama had become an unmaintained project. The author was not taking pull requests anymore, but there were pull requests to fix the issue, this issue and a couple of other issues as well. So I took it upon myself to fork PyLlama into PyLlama. I took all those pull requests and merged them into PyLlama, and I invited the existing contributors to PyLlama to come join as collaborators to this new project so that we can maintain this project as a community together. So that's the story of how this project was born and how it became a community maintained project. So using PyLlama is really simple. You just install it, pip install PyLlama. I would recommend that you go ahead and try it. And to run this on your own project, you just need to get into your source code directory, which has got all your Python source code files, and just run PyLlama. That's it. And if you don't get any output, that is a good thing. It means there are no issues in your code. However, if you do get a report like this, which means there are issues and you can take a look at them and fix them, this report was generated by running PyLlama on itself. So ironically, PyLlama itself has about 20 or so issues. We will fix them in future, whenever that comes. So I'll just leave you with the project URLs. If you're interested to try it out, that is the GitHub URL, github.com/pyfocus/pyLlama. And if you are interested to contribute to it or even help us maintaining the project, I welcome you to the project. Please visit the GitHub project page, create new issues and pull requests there, and let us keep this project alive. Thank you very much.